Well, as far as expectations go, we really try to not have expectations. At the risk of sounding cliche, one of my mantras is to expect nothing and to be ready for anything. So we don't want to limit ourselves to any expectations that we might set forward. At the same time, we don't want to sort of adhere to expectations that might not come to fruition and then experience extreme disappointment. So we try to put ourselves in a position to take advantage of opportunities as they arise and just to work hard and be the best we can be. As far as goals go, they're along those same lines, both for the men's and the women's teams. We've talked a lot last fall over the offseason and this preseason about process-oriented goals more than results-oriented. We want to commit to the training. We want to commit to being the best teammates that we can be, being able to trust your teammates, pursuing excellence. We talk a lot about pursuing excellence as opposed to perfection. And we talk a lot about gaining more respect on a national stage as far as being as competitive as possible and being in every race that we attend. So those are really the goals that we try to focus on over the course of the season. And rowing is a very team-oriented sport. It's the most team-oriented sport I've ever been associated with. It's not a very statistics-driven sport, so you don't hear a lot about individual athletes. Everybody is as important as everybody else. True, there are stronger, more fitter, technically more proficient rowers out there. But as far as the key returners go, we've got, on the women's side, we've got 7 athletes who participated or were part of the Varsity 8 at some point last season, including 3 seniors. So that's bringing back a lot of really good experience as far as the women's team goes. The men's team, similarly, we've got 6 athletes who rode in the Varsity 8 at one point or another last year, including 4 seniors. So there's a lot of experience on both sides, both squads. It's kind of an interesting team makeup that we have this year. Talked about the experience that we've got for both squads, but we've also got a pretty solid younger element on the team. We've got those returning seniors and returning varsity athletes, but I think on the women's team we've got 7 freshmen, men's team 8, if I'm counting correctly, and some of those have high school rowing experience, many of them don't, but I expect that along with team depth also, that the freshmen are going to play a pretty key role in contributing to top-end speed as well. And I think we've done a really good job of making progress with some of those goals I talked about, and just committing to the training and really putting themselves out there, having the courage to take a risk and dealing with failure as an opportunity to learn and move forward from there. The women's side, we've been riddled with injuries on the women's team, which has taken up a lot of our energy during the preseason camp, as we've liked to call it, sort of dealing with those injuries. But they're coming along. I think most of those athletes are recovering and rehabbing, and I think we'll be ready to go for spring break. Regardless of that, the healthy athletes have been performing at the highest level that I've seen since I've been here in the 6 years that I've been associated with the program. On paper, at least, the women's team is faster than it's ever been. Now, whether or not that translates to boat speed sort of remains to be seen. So those are some unanswered questions. The men, again, have been working hard, have been doing the training as well, much healthier squad, but I really think you're still trying to search for an identity, we're trying to bring some of their abilities, capabilities into focus a little bit better and what kind of team they're going to be. So a lot of unanswered questions with the men. And I think with both squads, our spring break training trip is going to answer a lot of questions. I think we'll come out of it with a much better picture of what kind of team we're going to be and what we're going to be capable of accomplishing. So I'm looking forward to that. We look forward to all the competition. We've got, I suppose the key date would be the conference championship on April 26th at the end of the season. But, we've scheduled probably the most challenging schedule that we've had in program history. We've got some new teams on the schedule we've never raced before. Hobart, William Smith, St. John Fisher, University of Rochester, Canisius College, along with the list of top end programs that we race year in and year out: Williams, Worcester Polytech, and closer to home, Marietta College, Washington College, both conference opponents. So I'm looking forward to, we're planning a trip up to Geneva, New York, to see some of those new schools, so that's going to be very interesting. The trip up to Worcester, Massachusetts, it's always fun because we get to see some top-level Division III competition from a different region. And then I think that, you know, we're gonna be facing teams. Our goal is to go to the line with confidence that we're going to be competitive in any race that we go to. I think there are going to be crews that we should beat. There are going to be crews out there that are going to be faster than we are. My hope is that by the end of the season, all that experience is going to add up and put us in a position to be competitive for medals at the conference championships. Although I think that this year there's going to be a lot more parity in the conference than there's been in the last few years. So it'll be a really fun regatta, I think.